I got to get this brought up on my phone. I'm going to take you guys to the studio with me, but I want to hear if there's any announcements after the decision. Thayer, let's roll. All right, guys. Amazing fight. Come on in, boys. Britt, can you get the dogs? All right, Danger's in. Incredible fight. So, Volkanovski dealt with the wrestling. And you could definitely see the size. Like, that was a big part of this narrative coming in, is the size against Volk in favor in Islam. You could see it. Like, the people that came to that conclusion were right to do so. It was very meaningful. We just get reminded, right? And we get reminded every single time, and I do mean every single time, that size is a disadvantage. The hardest guy to fight is the guy one weight class underneath you. We see that smaller guy's cardio, right? He can hold up just a little bit longer. He's carrying a little bit less weight. We can see that, there, you see me all right? Mm-hmm. We can see that the speed is there. We see some of the tacticalness is there. When you fight Islam Makhachev, okay? This goes for Khabib as well. There is a misconception where your eyes will tell you what great takedown experts they are. You'll come to that conclusion because every fight and every round, they get a takedown, right? Well, no, not really. Actually, no, that's really not right. You can't take a guy down with one leg. You saw Islam shooting at their high crotches and single legs. If you have one leg, you have nothing. You saw what a hard time Khabib had getting Conor down in their first fight in the open with one leg. I just share that with you. They're great at getting takedowns once your back's up against the fence. So if you're going to fight one of these guys, before you go out and think, I got to fill it up with Craig Jones and Jordan Burroughs and wrestle every damn day, yeah, okay. Or just keep your back off the fence. Easier said than done, I admit. But make sure that you do acknowledge the distinction. Okay. Volkanovski goes out there, gets his back off the fence. It's real simple. He kept his back off the fence. He circled. He knew when he needed to, and he wasn't all defensive. When we see other athletes put in the spot of Volkanovski with it all on the line, where the victory seems extremely unlikely, but the moral victory does seem within reach, within a grasp. And what that moral victory is, it's just that I'm going to make it. I'm going to make it the whole time. I'm going to go all five rounds with them. When they do that from a defensive posture. We can see who those people are that are doing those mental deductions right away because they're the one that are being responsive as opposed to one that's being responded to. Volkanovski was offensive tonight. He stood his ground, he checked his range, but then he began to throw. Volkanovski went orthodox southpaw, far more times than Islam did. Volkanovski went for just as many takedowns as Islam did. I get that he did not get them. I'm sharing with you, Islam only went for like 3 or 4 takedowns. Volkanovski went for 3 or 4 takedowns. Great way to shut down a guy's offense? Put him on the defense. Simple strategy. Hold on, guys. Hold on. See, this is so disappointing. So, they just made the announcement. They gave it to Islam. And I, of course, am saying this with some tongue-in-cheek, but not completely, right? There's something in every industry known as an industry standard. So you'll have the rules of the industry. You'll have the unified rules. You'll have these 3 judges that came in from all over the world and scored a contest within the 10-9-month system. But you're also going to have an industry standard. And whatever happened to the good old day, when you go on the road, the hometown guy wins. Did you guys ever follow the Olympics in 1996, the year Kurt Angle won it, just by example? It was on American soil. All the Americans won it, at least proportionately. How about the last Olympics that were in Tokyo, and all of a sudden there's a whole bunch of Japanese winners? That's the way you do it. You go to a distance in a great fight like that that was supposed to be a blowout. You have a sold-out arena cheering for Volkanovski. If you're a judge with any level of industry standard that follows our sport, you rip Islam off and you give it to Volkanovski. And I am only partly kidding about that.